Alzheimer's disease is an irreversible progressive brain disorder that slowly destroys memory and thinking skills. And eventually, the ability to carry out simple tasks. It is associated with abnormal accumulation of beta-amyloid protein in the brain. This protein forms plaques that disrupt communication between brain cells, contributing to cognitive decline. Lecanemab is a novel treatment for Alzheimer's disease that targets amyloid plaques in the brain. It is a humanized immunoglobulin gamma-1, or IgG1, monoclonal antibody. Lecanemab selectively targets the most neurotoxic beta-amyloid aggregates, the oligomers and protofibrils. Once bound to beta-amyloid aggregates, it helps the body's immune system clear the plaques from the brain via phagocytosis by microglia. This prevents amyloid beta deposition before plaques develop and removes existing plaques. By targeting and neutralizing amyloid beta proteins, lecanemab addresses a fundamental aspect of the Alzheimer's pathology. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration granted traditional approval to lecanemab in 2023, following the confirmatory Clarity AD trial, published in the New England Journal of Medicine that verified its clinical benefit. In this clinical trial, 1,795 adults were randomized to receive either placebo or lecanemab intravenously every 2 weeks. The primary efficacy endpoint was the change from baseline in the score on the clinical dementia rating sum of boxes, a validated measure of cognition and function in Alzheimer's disease. At 18 months, mean scores on this measure had worsened in both groups, indicating increased impairment. The mean change was smaller in lecanemab group, indicating less cognitive and functional decline. In essence, lecanemab slowed the rate of disease progression by about 27% after 18 months of treatment in patients with early Alzheimer's symptoms. This effect translated to a roughly 6-month delay in symptom progression. In addition to this, people taking lecanemab saw a sharp reduction in amyloid levels in their brain, as measured by brain scans. The most common side effects of lecanemab are infusion reaction, usually after the first dose, and amyloid-related imaging abnormalities. Infusion reactions occurred in 26.4% of participants on lecanemab in the Clarity AD study. These were typically mild to moderate in severity. Symptoms included fever and flu-like symptoms, such as chills, generalized aches, feeling shaky, and joint pain, nausea, vomiting, changes in BP, and oxygen desaturation. While infusion reactions can be dangerous, the majority of infusion reactions related to lecanemab were easily treatable and not severe. Monoclonal antibodies directed against aggregated forms of amyloid beta can cause amyloid-related imaging abnormalities, or ARIA, including brain swelling, called ARIA-E, and brain bleeding, called ARIA-H. ARIA occurred in 12.6% of all participants, based on MRI, in the Clarity AD trial. Most ARIA with lecanemab is asymptomatic. These incidences typically resolved on their own within 4 months. A few cases, about 2.8%, were symptomatic. Symptoms can include headache, visual disturbances, and confusion. It should be noted that the incidence of ARIA was substantially higher among patients who were APOE4 allele carriers, especially those homozygous carriers. Lecanemab is the first treatment approved for the treatment of Alzheimer's disease that is specifically designed to modify the disease's progression. This represents a significant advancement in the field of Alzheimer's research and treatment. While lecanemab does not cure Alzheimer's disease, it does modestly slow the rate of progression in the earlier stages. For people living with dementia, this means that lecanemab would allow them to live independently for longer. Lecanemab has been approved in the US, Japan, and China. Applications for approval have also been submitted in other countries and regions. An open-label extension study of Clarity AD is ongoing to provide additional safety and efficacy data beyond 18 months. There are also ongoing studies evaluating subcutaneous dosing of lecanemab. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.